It's AumSum time!
What does soda do to your body? It makes my skin glow. No.
Huh?
Sodas contain high amounts of sugar. Within 20 minutes of drinking soda, the high sugar content enters our bloodstream and sends our pancreas into overdrive, thus causing it to produce a burst of insulin. However, over time, this can lead to diabetes. Also, as we drink more and more sodas, the high sugar content tricks our liver to convert this sugar into fat, which gets deposited around our vital organs, thus causing them to dysfunction. Sodas also contain various acids. These acids, combined with the sugar, can erode the tooth enamel, thus damaging our teeth. Phosphoric acid present in sodas is specifically believed to interrupt the process of absorption of calcium by bones, thus making them brittle. Besides this, overconsumption of sodas is also linked to kidney and heart-related diseases. Why don't we drink seawater?
Ha! Simple! Because it tastes salty.
You are right. But besides taste, we don't drink seawater because it contains extreme amount of salt, which can have dangerous effects on our body.
Really?
Indeed. Now, normally in our body, the amount of water and salt inside and outside our cells is the same. However, if we drink seawater, the amount of salt outside our cells will increase, making the outside region much more concentrated. Hence, to dilute the outside region and maintain balance, inside and outside the cells, the water present inside the cell starts flowing outside, causing our cells to shrink.
Dude, this can have really dangerous consequences, right?
Absolutely. Moreover, to remove the extreme amount of salt, our kidneys will produce more urine, making us urinate more water and thus causing severe dehydration. How much water should you drink per day?
68.2735649.81 liters.
No. Up to 60% of the human adult body is water. But every day, we lose some of this water through sweat, urine, etc. So we need to replenish it. Now, there's a popular 8x8 rule which says, every day one should drink 8 glasses, each containing 8 ounces of water. Whereas, the Institute of Medicine suggests that the total water intake, including all beverages and food, should be 2.7 liters for women and 3.7 liters for men. However, no single formula fits everyone, but our amazing body itself tells us when we need water. For example, dark yellow urine is usually a very good sign of dehydration. Exercise, climate, and conditions like diarrhea, vomiting, etc. can lead to additional water loss. So, our body makes us feel more thirsty. This brings us to the conclusion that the water needs vary from person to person and situation to situation. Topic: osmosis. How do fish drink water?
That's easy. Using a straw.
No. Fish take in water usually through their mouth or gills, depending on whether they live in freshwater or saltwater. Freshwater fish takes in water mainly through its gills.
But why?
Because it has less water and more salt concentration in its blood than the surrounding water. Hence, due to osmosis, water from the surrounding flows through the gills into its bloodstream. However, as the fish is continuously taking in water, it urinates a lot and removes excess water. Saltwater fish takes in water through its mouth.
Oh, really?
This is because its blood has more water and less salt concentration than the salt water around it. Hence, to maintain the balance, the fish gulps salt water through its mouth, filters the water for its use, and expels excess salt while urinating.